Hello, welcome to the video tutorial on creating a pfSense virtual machine in Hyper-V hypervisor. After this video you will have a pfSense firewall without a physical device. I introduce how to create separate one in LAN interfaces. Besides, I created a new Windows virtual machine connected to pfSense via LAN interface like in a real environment. I recommend you use version 2.7.0 to create a pfSense virtual machine. I tried with newer version but no success. In the Hyper-V hypervisor I create new virtual switches to create different one in LAN interfaces for the firewall. I create a new virtual switch connecting to the internal network, pfSense SLAN port will connect to this virtual switch. Next I create a new virtual switch connected to the outside network. This virtual switch helps pfSense connect to the internet. After I finished creating the virtual switches, I created a new virtual machine named pfSense. Generation 2. You assign memory to the firewall, minimum 1 GB. Next you configure the network connection for pfSense. First, you configure the one connection for the firewall, the LAN connection will be added in a later step. Then you set up the hard drive for the virtual machine, I recommend you create a 20 GB hard drive for pfSense. Now browse to the pfSense installation file that has been downloaded to your computer. These are the basic steps to create a pfSense virtual machine. Next, change the settings for the pfSense virtual machine as follows. As mentioned, I added a new network interface named LAN for the pfSense firewall. Because for a firewall or router there are at least two interfaces. You change the boot order to ensure the pfSense virtual machine boots from the hard drive. Uncheck Enable Secure Boot. Before installing the operating system, make sure you have set up the pfSense virtual machine as above. Now you connect to the virtual machine and start installing the operating system. Follow these steps to install pfSense on a virtual machine in the Hyper-V hypervisor. Most of the time you just need to press Enter to follow the default options. You choose Yes to delete the data on the hard drive and start installing pfSense on it. After completing the installation you will be asked to restart the virtual machine and begin setting up pfSense for the first boot. On the pfSense virtual machine there are two network interfaces and I will set up which is the WAN interface and which is the LAN interface. In this case I set HN0 as the WAN interface of the firewall. And set interface HN1 as LAN interface of pfSense. As you can see the WAN interface is assigned an IP address from the DHCP server on my physical router. I see that the IP address range on the two interfaces is the same. This will cause an error during use, so I will change the IP address on the LAN interface of the firewall. To connect to pfSense, I created a new Windows virtual machine and connected it to the firewall via the LAN interface. In the Hyper-V hypervisor I created a new Windows 11 virtual machine. In this video I mainly introduce how to install pfSense in Hyper-V so I will skip how to create a Windows virtual machine. I just note that you configure the network connection for the Windows Virtual Machine as LAN to ensure that the Windows Virtual Machine and the pfSense Virtual Machine can connect to each other. I'll fast forward the process of creating a Windows Virtual Machine and how to install the operating system. This is a Windows Virtual Machine after completing the operating system installation. And this is the IP address assigned by the pfSense firewall. On the Windows Virtual Machine, I open any browser and access the pfSense firewall. The default IP address of pfSense is 192.168.1.1. Default username is admin, default password is pfSense. After successfully logging in, you will be guided through basic configuration instructions for pfSense. You change the firewall name, set up the DNS address. Next, you set the time zone where you live. Then you set up the WAN interface. There are a few different ways, but in this case I set up DHCP mode. As I mentioned, I changed the address on the firewall's LAN interface to avoid conflicts. Next, I set up an admin password for pfSense. Because I changed the LAN interface address, so I use the command to let Windows get the new IP address from pfSense. This is the new IP address allocated from pfSense. I access pfSense using the new LAN interface address. Above are the steps to create a pfSense firewall in Hyper-V hypervisor on Windows computers, and how to connect to it. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck.